गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, इन प्रीवियस वीडियो वी स्टडीड अबाउट द क्वाड्रेटिक इक्वेशन एंड हाउ टू सॉल्व अ क्वाड्रेटिक इक्वेशन। वी स्टडीड टू मेथड्स, फैक्टराइजेशन मेथड एंड वी स्टडीड दिस फॉर्मूला आल्सो। दिस इज कॉल्ड श्रीधराचार्य फॉर्मूला। टुडे वी शैल सी हाउ टू अप्लाई दिस फॉर्मूला एंड हाउ टू प्रेडिक्ट द नेचर ऑफ द रूट्स। सो इन दिस फॉर्मूला इफ यू राइट the standard equation ax square plus bx plus c equal to 0, the coefficient of x square is a, coefficient of x is b, and constant term is c. For example, if I take x square plus 7x plus c equal to 0, then what is a here? A will be 1, b equal to 7, and c equal to 12. So if we put this value in the above formula, using formula, x will be minus b, that is minus 7 plus minus under root b square, that is 7 square minus 4 into 1 into 12 upon 2a, that is 2 into 1, that is minus 7 plus minus under root 49 minus 48 upon 2, that is minus 7 plus minus under root 1, that is 1 upon 2. So if we take plus sign, if positive sign is taken, then x will be minus 7 plus 1 upon 2, that is minus 3. And if we take the negative sign, if negative sign is taken, then x will be equal to minus 7 minus 1 by 2, that is minus 8 by 2, equal to minus 4. So in this way, we can find the value of x. There will be two possible values depending on here we take plus sign or minus sign. As we know, every quadratic equation, the powers on the variable is 2, and the fundamental theorem of algebra says the number of solutions will be equal to the powers, highest powers on the variable. So since here the highest power on the variable is 2, so it will have 2 solutions. So using this formula, we can solve the problems of the quadratic equation also. Then how to predict the nature of the roots of the quadratic equation without solving it? So nature of roots, the next topic of this will be how to predict about the nature of the roots. Nature of the roots. To predict the nature of the roots, we have to find discriminant of the quadratic equation. Discriminant delta RD is equals to b square minus 4ac. The value which is written inside the bracket, inside the root. And there will be three cases. Case first, if b square minus 4ac is greater than 0, then roots are real and distinct. Roots are real and distinct. The case second is, if b square minus 4ac equal to 0, then roots are equal and real. And case third is, if b square minus 4ac is less than 0, then roots are not real. Only in these two cases, case first and second, if b square minus 4ac is greater than 0, or b square minus 4ac equal to 0, then only the roots are real. And here roots are unreal, or imaginary, as we can say. Roots are unreal or imaginary and distinct. Distinct means different, unequal. One more important point, if one root is a plus root b, then under root must be a minus root b. And if the roots are not real, it is imaginary, then if z is the one root, complex number it will come, then z bar will be then the root. That is beyond your syllabus, because you have not studied so far the complex numbers. So in this first you should know that if root comes in the irrational form, so if one root is a plus root b, other must be a minus under root b, and this case will come if and only if this b square minus 4ac, it is not a perfect square. So and this case, second case is always used. Sometimes there will be given in the question that if the roots are equal, find the value of particular constant. So if the roots are equal, we have to use the concept that discriminant must be 0, that is b square minus 4ac will be 0. So using that, we can find the value of this. Or we have to apply b square minus 4ac equal to 0, and you have to put the value of b, a and c in it, and you can solve to get the value of any particular constants. So this concept will be useful in solving the problems of the nature of the roots. And the last exercise of the quadratic equation is story type problems. So in the story type problems, whatever the concept we have studied so far, the same concept will be used. Only the difference is, instead of prepared equation, you have to prepare equation from the given conditions. Means first we have to form the equation, quadratic equation, and then we have to solve. For example, suppose you have one question is there. Find the two natural numbers whose sum of square is 41. So two consecutive natural numbers. So whenever you have to take two consecutive natural numbers, x and x plus 1. If 3 are to be taken, x plus 1 and x plus 2. 4 are to be taken, x plus 1, x plus 2, x plus 3. And this is applicable for not only natural number, but also for the integers of 2. If two consecutive integers are to be taken, we shall take x plus 1. If two consecutive whole numbers are to be taken, we shall take x and x plus 1. Similarly, if there is even two consecutive odd number or two consecutive even number, then we shall take x and x plus 2. If you have to assume two consecutive even number, then you have to take x and x plus 2. And the same is true for the odd numbers also. And then you have to frame the equation. For example, one question is, find two consecutive natural number, sum of whose square is 41. So let the numbers are x and x plus 1. Then according to question, sum of their square means x square plus x plus 1 whole square equal to 41. Then now we can solve it to get the value of x by quadratic process. And if you put the value of x here, you get the required quadratic, required natural numbers are required numbers. So using these concepts, try to complete your maths copy up to quadratic equation. And after quadratic equation, the next chapter we shall start after the summer vacation. Thank you.